Hey, what's going on, everybody? Marty here with Comic Book Fanatics, and I am going to do an unboxing for you of this beautiful Batman Noel version of Batman Arkham Origins from Prime One Studio. I ordered this from Sideshow Collectibles, and I got this in probably about a week or so ago. But I was kind of contemplating whether to do a video or just open it up and take a few pictures and post it on the Instagram and post it on the Comic Book Fanatics Facebook group. So I asked a few people on there whether I should do video or is pictures just fine? And they wanted to see a video. So due to all the followers' requests, I am going to do a video. Now, it's been a while since I've actually done, a video where I'm actually talking to the camera, talking to everybody out there, and going through the whole unboxing process. But, I'm just a little rusty, so please forgive me. And without any further ado, I'm just going to go ahead and get started with the whole spiel and the unboxing and everything. So, as you see, very beautiful, beautiful presentation on the box. As I mentioned earlier, this is from Prime One Studios, and I have number 190 out of 750, so they're very limited. Only 750 of these bad boys were made. So here we go, and here's the side view of it, and just kind of expands out from the front of the artwork on the front. And I can swear this is almost like glow in the dark, because when I turn off the lights in here sometimes, and it just looks like it glows in the dark. So it could be, it could not be, it just could, you know, be me, I don't know, just seeing shit, but nevertheless. Anyways, this is the Batman Arkham Origins Noel version. It's a polystone statue, it's a 1/3 scale, and this is the exclusive version. So, alright, I will try not to talk anymore, and we'll get to just me doing the unboxing. Alright, so what do we have here? We have the assembly instructions. Now, I'm not sure if you can see that. You probably can't, but it just kind of gives you an overview of what it's supposed to look like. Okay? This one, put this aside. Now, here's the tricky part, especially when you have to do it alone. The last time I did an unboxing as big as this, I had my boy Ray here to help me out, so we'll see what it looks like. Alright. I don't know if you guys hear that panting. Outside, go out. Sorry about that. Okay, so let's go ahead and put it on the side. And this is where it gets a little bit tricky, because you want to be very careful, and I don't want to tip it on its head so much and damaging anything, but usually they do a really good job of packaging. So, and the only way I can really get this is just really softly and slowly tilt this down so I can slide the box up. Here we go. Right, there it is. There it is. It is out. Let's go ahead and put this to the side here. That way I can go ahead and tip it back over. Alright. And now we want to look where it says top, which is right here. I'm going to do this very, very carefully. So I haven't heard anything. I haven't heard anything shift, so that's good. And remove this tape here. I wonder if there's a beginning portion to this. If not, I got my trusty little blade here, so we'll go ahead and do that. Okay. this. This is really well packaged, and it got some really nice material that come along. It almost looks like silk. Look at that, see? Polyester silk, I don't know. But this is the first time that I've ever opened a statue where something like this came with it and wrapped up. Because usually they'll either use wax paper or some type of tissue paper. Okay, so let's see what we have here so far. They give you three heads. Wow. Here's one. I'll do a close-up for you guys, so don't worry. If you can't see it right now, that's fine. I'll do a close-up of the different heads. Here's another one, more of an angry one. And wow, really angrier. So normal, angry, and angrier. All right. Then, let's see what else. Anything on this side? Yeah. Looks like we have a little bit more. And here is his gauntlet holding a batarang. Okay. Then his other side. There's two. So one just as a fist, and the other one holding his batarang. So let's put this here right now. So here's one thing. I'll have to take this out and place it somewhere soft because the base, I have to take out the base. So before I even want to start doing anything, I definitely want to make sure that happens. All right, so here is, wow, this is heavy. This is about, I don't know, maybe 10 pounds, I think. It's really nice too. Got some weight. Do some bicep curls with this. All right, so let me put this down real quick. All right, and as you can tell, this material, see that? Really nice polyester. Really well done when it comes to them packaging. Packaging is really, really nice too. That in there. And what I'll do is I'll cut this open right here first. I'm assuming the base is probably in here. Can you guys tell I'm a little rusty in doing these videos? I'm trying not to talk too much. Make this video not so boring. So if you don't want to just sit through this entire unboxing of this video, I don't know, play it on your way home or something, listen to it, watch it on if you're in traffic or if you're bored and what have you. That way you guys don't. Alright, so got another pork bottom piece here, and of course it looks like the base. So let me put this right here for now. And once again, it's wrapped up in this really, really nice material. The base is huge. Wow. And it is in there really good. This is gonna take a minute. Try this. Yeah, this is in there really good, so I don't have to worry about things shifting around in here. There we go. Alright. So let's move this down. Okay. Have a base piece right here. Alright. A few more other parts, I guess. Okay. Just top of his body. His shoulder. breast. Oh, look. So you got another gauntlet here for his right hand. So if you don't want to display it with the Batarang, I say Batarang, is that right? Batarang? Am I saying that right? Then you have that choice as well. Then, oh look, this is probably part of the base piece. Man. There it is right there. Okay, so let's do this. We'll go ahead. I'm just gonna leave that under there for now. I'll take it off when I do a more of a close-up and take some close-up photos here. So we'll take Batman, and as you'll see on here, if you got one of these, that there's pegs that you slide them into just like that. There we go. Now, one thing I probably didn't see is his cape. So I'm assuming it's probably under this. So let's move these out so when I flip this over, there's no issue. Because I'm not gonna put this on yet. Because usually the cape that I notice in many other Batmans that I've had usually fits right under this. Okay, so put this right on there. See that? This is probably where the cape is. Alright, so. I lost my knife for a second. It's very carefully because I know the cape is going to be a material. Because it doesn't feel heavy enough for it to be a polystone piece. Leather material. I'll throw this back on here. And as I mentioned, I'm gonna display the one with him holding his Batarang. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this back in here, cover it up so there's no further damage to it. Okay. Let's check out the cape. Huge cape. And usually these capes are really poseable. So, yeah, remember the wax paper I was telling you guys about? Kind of like the tissue paper that you usually come in, besides the polyester material. So, yep, looks like it's a really nice leather, too. Here it is. Look at that. This is how far this goes, right? And then it's got some weathering down here as well. So this cape's been through something then. So this is really nice. Okay. And as I mentioned, usually this will go on first before the shoulder piece will go in. So looks like that fits right here, just like that, and it is poseable. It feels some wiring in here, so that way you can kind of pose it the way you want it. So, pull that in there, and then we'll take this upper portion, see if that will hold in. There you go, just like that. Okay, then this looks like, now it's just kind of matching up the pieces here. That goes right there. this around so you guys have a better view of it. How's that? Okay. Then we're going to put his left arm in. And it's magnetized, obviously, because the way it goes in, the way it comes out, it just kind of sucks it in there. Then, bam, just like that. So I'll do like a close-up video after this, so just kind of stay tuned for that. And what I'll do is I'll just kind of pan up and down on him. But it is overall a very, very beautiful and huge piece from Prime One Studios. And Prime One is known for making huge statues like this. I don't think I've ever seen a medium size or 1/6 scale or a quarter scale. But this is definitely huge. So I'm looking, I also have the Harley Quinn and the Deathstroke on pre-order as well. And this is just something additional to my Batman collection. And I will get around to doing an updated room tour of my Batman room / Star Wars room, okay? So anyways, thanks for watching, everybody. I really appreciate it. My apologies if I seem a little rusty, because I am. Stay tuned for the close-up of this, and I hope you like this unboxing. If you already own one of these in your collection, tell me how you feel about it. Tell me what you think about it. If you like the statue or not, and if you're just watching this video and you're on the fence line, or you just wanted to watch it just to enjoy the video, let me know what you guys think, okay? So thanks a lot. Thanks for watching, and don't forget, collect what you love.